The web server controls are similar to the HTML controls in many ways. However, they may represent more complex elements, instead of mapping directly to existing HTML tags. To see a list of them, we can bring up the toolbox in Visual Studio and expand the standard controls. As we can see, ASP.NET has a large number of web controls available. To add one, we simply drag and drop the control where we want it placed. Double-clicking also works to position it wherever the character is located. Although this list contains some rich controls, such as the calendar, it seems at first glance that many of the simpler web controls overlap with the HTML controls. For example, there is no functional difference between a web button control and its HTML control counterpart. They are both server-side controls for the button element. This is really more of a convenience feature. The purpose of the HTML server controls is to make it easier to migrate an HTML page to ASP.NET, whereas the web controls have more relation to the .NET framework, so they offer more control from a programming standpoint. If we check the properties of the web control, we can see that they differ greatly from those of the HTML control. To get a better overview of the properties, we'll switch over to design mode and bring out the properties window. With the web button now selected, we can see all the properties that this web control has available. This is a great way to learn about the functionality of the web controls. For example, if we added a checkbox, we would quickly discover that its state was determined by the checked property. If we changed its default state to true in the properties window, the editor would add that property to the control. The property could of course just as well be used from the code page, both to get the property and to set it.